One of the things, Martha. It wasn't so simple that you rebelled against your godly name, Martha, but people around you were not worthy of the name, the treasure that is Martha. And, you know, like when God put on Joseph, gave Joseph as a young boy a dream, the people rejected. Yeah, he didn't, maybe didn't handle it the best, but people rejected who God created him to be. And so that gave you a negative to where, yeah, I'm sure there's a part of that that is true, that Jeannie sounded cool and you took it. And that is all true, but you didn't. If you'd have known, and if they'd treated that name with the respect God, it would have changed your view of that name totally. And so you're going to flow into that name. And one of the things I had shared with you about perseverance just last week, the perseverance, but administration will flow in the spirit for you, and you'll see things order even. I mean, it's so awesome you're sharing that. It's just such a beautiful flow in that, and you are a picture of perseverance. It doesn't matter the 64 years it took you to get into your name. The only thing that matters is that you're in the name, and that's all that all God sees. He doesn't see any of the rest. And Martha, Martha is a great name.
Yeah. She was bold.
Bold.
This just came to me. I forgot to share that part, but when I was, I don't know, I was in the shower the other night, I came bolting out of there, wrapped in a towel, and I said, I stopped in front of Don, and I froze. I said, Martha was bold. She had the courage to speak to Jesus and request of him, even if she was a bit out of line. He so lovingly corrected her,
yes,
and she got it. And by the time you hear from her next, she declares, I know you're the Christ, the, yes, Son of God. Yeah, wow.
There's so many things that she's walked into and done now since this name change that wouldn't have happened before.
Right.
I mean, at this wedding last Sunday that we flagged at, we went up and down the aisle, and she wouldn't have done that. And when we flagged, and the groom actually fell out in the Holy Spirit. It was pretty amazing. I mean, I've not had anybody do that yet when I flagged over him, but I mean, that as we went up and down the aisle, the atmosphere changed. People were just kind of, and it was a time of worship, that's what they were doing. Of course, that's where he had asked me to do this, and us as the Holy Spirit led us. And as I first went up the aisle, the atmosphere changed, and then she came
up. You
could
see,
and it was just,
as he went
incredible.
Up, slowly up the aisle, people just, just became fired up from just sitting, like sitting in a class, kind of almost, they just went, woo!
No, it's just so incredible.
I don't know what you mean, sir.
Martha.
That's fine. Just keep fretting. I don't know if you remember the women's conference that we were at when we were all little, we broke out little circles, and you were in my group.
Okay.
Do you remember that?
Uh-uh.
Was that 5-6 years ago? 5 or 6 years?
Oh. Don't expect me to remember that.
Well, I just remember you were this kind of really quiet, timid.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, you barely would, we were supposed to all, like, prophesy to the person next to us. And, you know, that was kind
of. Oh, I didn't tell all the details of how horribly, horribly shy.
And how horribly, not so much. But, yeah. But, yeah, and
good
the
way.
Woman, well, the, yes, the person you've become is just amazing.
Yes.
I mean, it's
thank
just
you.
But I remember that other person, and you are not that person. But it's cool to see. It's cool to see
thank
the difference
you.
God has made.
Kira?
I just looked up your name in Hebrew. It means she knows.
Whoa.
That's
yes,
prophetic. That's so you, because you operate in prophetic.
Thank you.
Isn't that awesome?
That is awesome.
I was last week, I was there at the wedding, but I was inside overseeing the